I know you. I know you as a host, but I don't really know your work as much until I saw you for the first Republican debate. You were fantastic on that.
Thank you.
I got to say, you did a great job with that. I was like, oh, this is fantastic. This has got to be, like, I mean, for people that don't know you, have to be like, oh, who is this person? She's phenomenal. Did your life change dramatically after that, or not really?
Well, so Donald Trump did not feel the same.
Yeah, no, he did not. No, he did not agree with that.
So
yeah.
it changed a little.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I can no longer go on Twitter.
Yeah. They can get harsh on the Twitter, the social media.
Yeah, I mean, it's been sort of a surreal 6 months because, you know, we never anticipated that anybody would react to the questions in that particular way.
Yeah.
But, you know, sort of keep your head down and shoulders back and try to forge forward.
But that was a big deal because I didn't think you were that unfair. Are you biased against, did you ask him the tougher questions, Donald Trump?
He got a tough question, but they all got tough questions. I mean, that opening round of the first debate in particular was all about electability. So we were trying to get to, what's your weak spot? You know, what's going to prevent you from getting the nomination? What's going to prevent you from winning against Hillary, who's going to be the likely Democratic nominee? And that's where I was going with him. But, you know, all those guys they kind of got it right in the kisser.
Yeah.
And, but, you know.
Dude, but that's your job as a moderator?
I think that's what you have to do. I mean, they want George Washington's job. So I'm a member of the press, and we're supposed to press.
Yeah.
And see if they're worthy.
Yeah, that's what you're supposed to do. So you do that, and then the next day this whole thing, and Trump was tweeting and things, and I just got out of control.
I heard. Yeah.
You handle it very well, by the way.
Thank you.
And now here comes this next GOP debate. Well, this is probably the seventh GOP debate was last week.
Yep.
Back on Fox, and they announced that you're moderating, one of the moderators again, and Donald Trump goes, I'm out. And you go, wait, what? And he goes, yeah, I'm out of this. If Megyn Kelly's involved, I don't know.
Well, he said it was about me, and then he said it was about a statement my boss put out, and then he said it was about, like, a gum wrapper on the floor. And, there were a lot of reasons that he gave, but so I don't know exactly why he didn't show up, but
really,
he did not show in the end.
But, I mean, did he not have any idea that you would be involved?
He knew. Fox announced it back in August, and then they re-announced it in December, but it wasn't until the actual week of the debate that I think it really dawned on him that we were going to go again. And, you know, once again, all those guys had tough questions. You know what I mean? Like, you got to wind up and do it. That's what they pay me to do.
Did you think he was going to show up last minute? And to go, surprise. Forgot about somebody. Yeah, guess what? I was hiding behind a wall. A giant wall. I've been here the whole time. Biased. Yeah.